Hello, I'm Dr. Davey Alleman. I'm excited to share with you some clinical tips and tricks that will help you become a better and more confident dentist. Now, dentistry is a very tricky, very comprehensive. There's a lot of avenues that you can go down a rabbit hole and become an expert in. And one thing that I am very passionate about is this topic of cracked teeth. I feel like there's a lot of ambiguity on what you should do when you encounter a tooth such as this, where we have a large composite, or this could be a large amalgam, and we're seeing signs of fatigue of the tooth structure. So the first thing we will do is we'll do a risk assessment. We'll analyze the residual tooth structure to see if we see cracks on the marginal ridges or peripheral rim fractures. Next, we will analyze the isthmus width, and then we will follow by analyzing the cusp widths, and in certain cases, a box that is greater than a certain depth. Now, all of these factors can contribute to how the tooth bends and flexes in a way that is not like a tooth that is non-restored. And so we make the diagnosis of a tooth that is structurally compromised when we see these red flags of peripheral rim fractures, large isthmus widths, thin cusps, and deep boxes. So you've now diagnosed that this tooth is structurally compromised. What should you do? Many dentists will simply ask the patient if this is symptomatic or asymptomatic. And oftentimes the patient will lie. And when the patient lies, you take them at their word and you say, well, I guess we'll see you in 6 months. And we're simply going to observe this tooth that is showing signs of fatigue or fracture. Now, the second thing we could do is not even see it. If you're not using high enough magnification, and we highly recommend that you use at least 4.5 to upwards of 10, so you can see the fractures and particularly help you when you're treating the fractures. So on this tooth, we see a crack on the distal and the mesial marginal ridge, but we don't know the direction or length or the severity of this crack. In order for you to assess this, you actually have to open up the tooth and begin to see if the crack is moving horizontal, oblique, or vertical. Each of these cracks can have very different clinical failures, or in some instances, a catastrophic failure where the tooth is ultimately lost. So here I've started with depth cuts as I'm going to do an indirect restoration to help visualize the fractures that I'm treating. After I've onlaid the distal portion of the tooth, I can see that the fracture is running in a vertical nature. The vertical cracks have a pathway to infect a pulp, kill a pulp, and in some instances, cause a tooth to be lost if it runs down the root. You have to be aggressive in how you treat these vertical fractures to prevent the clinical or catastrophic failures associated with this type of fracture pattern. In order to aid my visibility, I onlaid more cusps to ensure that when I do remove the fracture, that I get and obtain a crack-free peripheral seal. We always want this to be free of any decay or any fractures. So when we do a deep margin elevation and when we seal the tooth and rebuild the bottom portion, we then connect the tooth front to back, side to side, and eventually top to bottom when we put our enamel replacement. Here you can see we've started to trough and remove the fracture across that line. So we're moving buccal and lingual about the length of the burr until we no longer see this fracture present. Now, this fracture is still present at a depth of 8 millimeters. This is a time where most dentists feel very uncomfortable going another millimeter or 2 millimeters more for the fear of not being able to eventually restore this type of defect. So I want to focus on the isolation. The isolation with the adjunct of Teflon tape along with your rubber dam helps create a clear vision and a clear field for the peripheral seal zone that we're treating and removing the fracture. I view fractures not only as a structural defect, but also as a pathology that can infect a pulp or cause a tooth to be lost. At this point, after I've removed another millimeter and I'm now very close to crestal bone, we are beginning to see that the fracture has been eliminated in the peripheral seal zone. And at specific depths in what we call the central stop zone, we will stop and leave any of those fractures. The strength will be coming from the perimeter, not from the center. This is the compression dome that Graham Milicic talks about. After we have our crack-free peripheral seal zone, then we do what's called a deep margin elevation. We will have another video where we outline these protocols. If you want to learn more about training programs that we offer both in person and online, we highly encourage you to visit our website and our YouTube channel to find more information.